Tegan and Sara? That would be your cue, Tegan and Sara. Here we go. Should we open the door? The rest of the band.
Oh, thanks.
Hello.
We forgot it's soundproof. That is a soundproof
room.
Well,
we weren't completely clear if it was like we were supposed to just like come bursting out of there, yeah, or if it was like we're Canadian, so we just always want to let our American friends tell us what to do.
We appreciate that.
Happy belated Canadian Thanksgiving, by the way. I just realized Canada has a Thanksgiving too.
Do you know it's so
good
funny.
For you guys?
It's so interesting because I've heard that every like. You know, I've heard that a lot more this year, like people figuring it out. And I think it was partly due to like there was a huge piece in the New York Times about like, did you know that Canada also celebrates Thanksgiving? And it's not even when our Thanksgiving is. And so then I just started getting all these text messages on Thanksgiving from Americans like the emoji for like the turkey. And I was just like, what's happening?
Canadians are grateful too.
Yeah.
What is this concept? Well, welcome back to Chicago.
Thanks.
I believe it was about 4 years ago when you played our very first Anodo show. We were known as a different brand here. And there was an incident, Lou.
Yeah, well, it was at the Cubby Bear in Wrigleyville right next to Wrigley Field. And you, when we announced this was going on, we had the tickets for download. It was a free show. Mm-hmm. And you guys broke our internet.
Oh,
literally.
I do remember this. Oh, I know which show you're talking about.
Oh, my
Cubby.
God.
Yeah.
Our website didn't work right for like a week because people went nuts trying to get into that show to the point where we had to come to you guys and we're like, hey, if the line is nuts, would you be cool to do two sets? And you guys were like, yeah, sure, we'll do it. We got it in one, but you guys could not have been cooler about that.
And yeah. I remember it because I was really sick, too. I remember, like, everybody was sort of doing the guilty thing where they're like, we know that you're dying, but would you do two shows?
And double your work for tonight.
Let's see if I can even get through one. But no, that was so fun. I forgot. I didn't, no offense, but I didn't realize this was the same.
We have a different name now, but it's still the same.
Our minds just get wiped every year. They're just like, let's take all their memories out so that they don't say no to anything.
It was an amazing performance, though, at the Cubby Bear. I mean, almost as amazing as a room like this. Small, intimate, but still just, you guys killed it.
Well, we're really excited. You know what the truth is that we love doing the main show, like, you know, the production, and it's so fun. There's like, you get to play sort of a character on stage, but I think where we really enjoy being ourselves is like in the small, more intimate settings.
Incredible.
That's it. I stunned you with my with my honesty.
I still can't believe Canadians have a Thanksgiving.
He's stuck on that one.
Brilliant. Let's hear a song from Tegan and Sara here.
Awesome. Right. We're gonna play a song called Stop Desire.
Can't deny I'm begging for attention. Jumping in, hoping for some tension. Getting tired of making all this racket. Waiting on you to get your ass in gear. I didn't wanna be so invested. I played it cool and then I overdressed it. You were there, I was tired of this nonsense where you pretend you don't get me, feel me, want me. Like me, love me, need me tonight. If you're for my fire, you can't stop desire. Oh, 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 stop desire. Oh, 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 I've tried. Put your future on fire. You can't stop desire. Oh, 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 stop desire. Oh, 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 oh. Outside, another second you'll be walking on my wild side. You know I'm ready for anything to happen. Take this passion, turn it into action. Get me, feel me, want me. Like me, love me, need me tonight. If you feel my fire, you can't stop desire. Oh, 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 stop desire. Oh, 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 I've tried. Put your future on my fire. You can't stop desire. Oh, 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 stop desire. Oh, 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 right where I want you, back against the wall. Trust when I promise never let you fall. You're right where I want you, back against the wall. You can trust me, I'll never let you fall. You from my fire. You can't stop desire. Oh, 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 stop desire. Oh, 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 I try. Put your future my fire. You can't stop desire. Oh, 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 stop desire. Oh, 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 tonight. If you from my fire. You can't stop desire. Oh, 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 stop desire. Oh, 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 oh.
Thanks.
Tegan and Sara, talk about the song Stop Desire.
You know, I actually wrote the song. We were just about to go on tour with Fun. This was like a couple years ago. We were doing a big summer tour with them, and I went home, and it was supposed to be nice weather. I had gone back to Vancouver, and we thought it was going to be really nice, and it was super rainy and socked in, and I don't usually write a ton when we're touring a record, and we were in the middle of Heartthrob, and I just sat down and decided to write a song because I didn't want to go outside, and Stop Desire came out. It was so early, I didn't think it would even be considered for the record, but... we work with this awesome producer, Greg Kirsten, and I sent him the demo, and he was like, I think you guys should record that for the new record. And
there it is.
Yeah.
Now, Heartthrob was the last record from 3 years ago. When
yeah.
Kind of the start of your evolution,
yeah.
Your sonic evolution that began where you introduced new friends,
yeah.
So to speak.
Yeah.
What was that point where you decided to change directions?
We talked a lot about it even as early. I mean, some of these things, they sort of... they're like little tiny ideas that you're already thinking about years before you actually do it, you know? And I remember when we were making Sainthood, which was a record we put out in 2008, I had already started to be really cranky. Maybe even the end of The Con, which came out in like 2007, I remember starting to feel a bit cranky about indie rock and feeling like, you know, there were some... what I felt were limitations. Some of them were self-imposed, but some of them were just systemic within the genre itself. I didn't feel like we were getting the kind of attention that I thought maybe we deserved compared to some of our male friends. You know, like we were always sort of having to like prove ourselves over and over and over again. And I just was like feeling annoyed. And I remember I had sort of moved away from listening to a lot of indie rock, was listening to, I remember Alicia Keys had just put out a really amazing album that I was really obsessed with, specifically a song called Try Sleeping With a Broken Heart. And I remember thinking, I think I just want to like have like a minute, just like take some of these guitars out, really just sort of let the melodies and the, you know, the textures of the, you know, the keyboards and the synths and the rhythm tracks, the things that we were already building and demoing naturally ourselves, but instead of throwing a bunch of guitar on top, I was like, what would happen if we just like didn't focus on that? And so we already had started to talk about that years mm-hmm. before we made Heartthrob. It just takes a minute, I think, to sort of get on the same page.
Yeah.
And then also just let things kind of, you know, I didn't want to shock people. I wasn't like, okay, we're now in a metal band or something. Like,
yeah.
We wanted to sort of have a progression. But even songs as early as, you know, 2009, like the song like Alligator, which was on that Sainthood record. I mean, there's no guitars. It's just a piano kind of riff song. And it's like... you know, it's. I feel like without even our audience knowing, we were already starting to ease them into the idea of us not being a guitar-based band.
Yeah, but what would Tegan and Sara, the metal band, sound like?
I mean,
it would be awesome.
It would be fun.
Right.
I don't know if we have the voices for it, but it's. It would be
you
fun.
You can pull it off.
I mean, there's nothing more powerful than just, like, shredding on a guitar. Like, we have a band opening for us right now, Torres, and they just, like, the guitars are so rad, and it feels so good. But I don't know. Maybe we'll go back to it at some point, or not go back. I hate the idea of that. I mean, maybe they will become
well, we
part
always say
of our
like
future
this
again.
We started playing music right out of high school, like professionally, and that's nearly 20 years ago.
Yeah.
And so we played guitar
on every single song for 15 years, hundreds of shows a year. And I think like Sara said, we just started to feel maybe like we needed to try something different. It was sort of like changing up your workout, like going from running to CrossFit or
new
something,
workout.
You know?
That's all it is. I mean, I was a fan from the This Business of Art record from 2000. So
yeah,
I've been a fan of a very long time of Tegan and Sara.
That's amazing.
So I'm going to jump into the role of guy who states the obvious. You guys, identical twins. Mm-hmm. And I bring that up not just to point out and go, oh, cool, they're twins. I actually just had identical twin girls 8 months ago.
That's so nice.
And you guys.
You're so lucky.
Thank you. Yes, we are. My wife's actually here, too. And
Lou's wife, Janine, right there.
Congratulations.
You came up when we.
Yeah.
Right. Well, that's where I'm going with
sure
this. Because
they will be.
We find out we're having identical twin girls, and we're sitting there going, okay, so here's what we're going to have. How are we going to tell them apart? And I start thinking, is this going to be like The Shining? Like, come play with us, Danny? And she goes, no, they're going to be cool. They're going to be like Tegan and Sara.
Oh, that's
and I was
nice.
Like, yeah, that's the route I want them to go. That's, we don't want to be The Shining. We'd rather be the Tegan and Sara thing.
Well, that is really exciting, and if I have any advice to give as a
twin. That was my next question.
Yeah, as a twin, I would say, you know, there are so many things about us that are very, very, very different, but there are things that are similar, too, and I think there's nothing more traumatizing in all the years we've talked to twins than trying to force twins who are similar to be different or twins that are really different to be similar. Like, I think you just need to follow their lead. Sara and I went through phases where we really were attached to each other. We wanted to be in the same classroom. We wanted to go to the same extracurricular activity or buy the same snow jacket, you know, and my mom just let us do that. And then when we would want to resist being similar and be very different, she also encouraged that independence. So don't fall into the trap. We can't read each other's minds. We can't do anything special. We just share a very similar aesthetic.
So now where did you guys land on the whole getting the names wrong? But like if your mom and dad got you guys mixed up,
I think we handle it the same way we do now, which is that I get that the brain reads a face in a certain mm-hmm. way, and there's similarities to us that are, even for us, like when I was just backstage looking at live photos from last night, and there are photos where I have to be like,
cool.
Because it's like there's so many things similar about us, but then there are very different things about us too, but even we have trouble in a split second sometimes being like, oh yeah, that one, that's me.
I think too, there's also a real emphasis in, especially when it comes to twins, I think with everyone, but we think that we are looking at someone and that's totally how we recognize them. But for, you know, for parents especially, or people who are really close, you're picking up on gestures, the way someone holds their body, the way they move, or the way their energy is. And I think Tegan and I are really different. And for people like my parents who knew us, I mean, on a very intimate level, I mean, I could walk into a room and my mom would know it was me without even looking over. You know, just I think that we carry ourselves and energetically give off really different.
That's
different
our way
things.
Of saying you'll be fine. You'll be able to tell your kid apart.
It will
don't
be
worry.
Fine.
Yeah, don't worry.
Maybe they'll start a metal band.
See?
Maybe we can finally get a TV
and
they can
open
metal
for you
band.
Guys.
I was
like,
say,
this will come
I
full circle.
I don't think you should. The music industry is very, I'm not sure if that's the goal for the long term. I think that maybe more like an Ashley and Kate Mary Olson. What is their names?
Ashley Olson.
Yeah.
Hey, if they want to be billionaires. Actors.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool.
Get them
that's
into
fine.
Business.
Yeah.
Get
sure.
Them into
Daddy
business.
Doesn't need to work anymore, right? How about another song?
Yeah, absolutely.
And Sara.
Play a song called Boyfriend.
That you give me, wanna give it right back. I know you always win at this particular game. I need to know the rules if you want me to play. You treat me like your boyfriend, and trust me like a very best friend. Kiss me like your boyfriend. You call me up like you would your best. Turn me on like you would your boyfriend. I don't wanna be your secret anymore. I'm trying to be honest, cause I can't be nice. When I get around you, I can't hide the fact. I let you take advantage, cause it felt so good. I blame myself for thinking we both understood. You treat me like your boyfriend, and and trust me like a very best friend. Kiss me like your boyfriend. You call me up like you would your best friend. You turn me on like you would your boyfriend. I don't wanna be a secret. I don't wanna play the cracking game. Don't wanna spin the bottle again. You feel the same, you feel the same. You treat me like your boyfriend and trust me like a very best friend. Kiss me like your boyfriend. You call me up like you would your best friend. You turn me on like you would your boyfriend. I don't wanna be your secret anymore. You treat me like your boyfriend and trust me like a very best friend. Kiss me like your boyfriend. You call me up like you would your best friend. You turn me on like you would your boyfriend. I don't wanna be your secret anymore.
Tegan and Sara.
So something you guys did that is on a constant loop in my house. We have a 2-year-old, and you know where I'm going with this. The Lego movie, mm-hmm. Everything is awesome. Mm-hmm. It literally, my kid loves that movie, and that song is like he runs around screaming it. You worked with the Lonely Island on that, right?
Yeah.
So kind of walk us through that whole experience. I mean, just doing a song for such a major movie like that.
It was pretty. I mean, it's a very detached experience.
It's a modern experience.
Yeah, we never actually were in the room with the Lonely Island
That's
guys.
Crazy.
We just did everything remotely.
Well, technically, Sara and I were not in the room with each other. Yeah. I recorded with a team in Los Angeles, and then they sent the tracks, and Sara went to a studio and recorded.
I actually just did it at home.
Oh, did you do it at home?
Yeah.
And then they sent all those tracks to the Lonely Island, and then they did it in their studio, wherever they were at the time. They were doing a movie, and so all three of us were completely separate from each other.
How amazing is that? That it got broken down from like this major motion picture to like, well, I was in different studios. Well, yeah, I was at home, and I did it on my phone. And
this is
like,
why it
wow.
was such a cool experience to get to actually perform with them at the Oscars, because you know we know the Lonely Island guys, and specifically we know Andy for many years, and so we were friendly. We were really stoked to be sort of together working on this project. But then when the song was up for best song at the Oscars, they were like, oh, would you guys be into performing? We all made the energy and time to come out. We had to like do a bunch of rehearsals. We had to do like blocking rehearsals with the whole ensemble of cast, because there was like dancing and flipping and characters and astronauts, and it was like, I think they were worried we were going to get killed, and we nearly did many times. Like we certainly never do anything choreographed, so all of a sudden we have like, you know, like a Hollywood choreographer being like, and then it'll be 1, 2, 3, and then you're here, and then you're there, and watch out for the possum, and then we're Tegan and I are just like. We were like the least glamorous people probably ever to attend the Oscars, but it was super, super fun, and we had no idea that the movie would be so big, so it was one of those serendipitous things where we said yes, and then it actually became like a really kind of like one of those moments probably we'll talk about for the rest of our lives.
Well, it's not one of those annoying kid movies, so mom and dads are like, hey, you want to watch it? Great, put it on. <That's>
Yeah, it turned out to be, I mean, when they sent us the pitch for the movie, they sent us just a short little clip, and we both were like, okay, because you never know, right, when you commit to doing something, like you're like, but as soon as I saw the clip, I was like, okay, this looks smart. This looks really smart.
It was like the opening sequence.
Yeah.
It was cool.
And I liked the content and how subversive it was, but then how cool it would be for kids to attach to something that had been so significant to us as young people. So that was cool.
And in the past couple of years, since your sound has evolved, you've made some new friends, including your time with Taylor Swift.
Yeah, yep. Our time with Taylor Swift was like maybe 3.5 minutes on stage performing the song Closer.
I was going to ask, is she the nicest person ever that I
In that 3 minutes, she was the nicest person we've ever met. Yeah. During rehearsal, she came over and she was like, just so you know, I have 9 background singers. So when it comes time to do the final section, I'm going to count down the audience. and I want to make 15,000 people jump up and down to the final chorus of Closer. And okay. the way she choreographed, like, she's a boss. Like, she was up there. She was just organizing everyone, telling everyone what to do. Everyone loves her so much. Her team was so cool. Sara and I were just in awe. She was amazing. And when we went on stage to perform, when the countdown started, we're so old school, so I was just like, you know, keep the mic near your face and sing its full voice and sing as well as you could. And when I watched back, I mean, Taylor's just jump. I mean, she's so tall. She's like practically, I mean, she just was jumping over top of us. It was incredible. And the whole audience, just like this arena, just started jumping up and down. It was the coolest thing I'd ever seen. It was amazing.
She is really, really nice. Like, you just, yeah. I mean, I don't know if, I mean, if I had to testify to her niceness, I would certainly be, it would be authentic. You know, I would say, like, she made us jam. She made us jam and biscuits, and she was very, really sweet. Her parents, she came off stage from her show and came into our dressing room and was like, hey, guys, like, let's hang out. And we were just, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I don't know anything about her other than one experience.
Sure. Jam and biscuits.
Nice. The jam and biscuits was delicious. And it's very, very good manners.
She seems like a very polite woman.
Very polite.
Now, is there anyone on your list of somebody you would like to work with?
There's so many, but it's sort of, I always envy people who feel like they can just say anything they want and are super confident about just declaring, like, I want to work with whatever this person. And I'm just like, aren't they embarrassed or aren't they worried that the person would be like, ew, I would never work with them. Yeah. But so there are a few people, but I'm not going to tell you.
Okay. Thanks for a great conversation.
I'm just going to think about it and manifest it in my own mind. And then if it happens, then that's great. But if it never happens, then I never have to live
probably
in the shame.
Best.
Yeah, like you're covering your bases.
The shame shadow. I'll never have to live in it if I don't.
Every once in a while, people will push us, like, they'll, like, the record label or people around us will be like, we should reach out to someone to get a collaborator. We should get a featuring vocalist on your record. And Sara and I are just like, we're too awkward. We're just like, Sara's my featuring vocalist on every song. So
I think Shame Shadow could be the name of your metal band.
Oh, that's a good one. Yeah. There is a Canadian metal band that covered us.
Oh, yeah?
If you're at all interested in hearing what Tegan and Sara sound like as a metal band, but with a male lead singer, there's a band called Cancer Bats, and they covered a song called So Jealous.
Yeah, and it's
record, kick ass.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah.
Pretty sweet. Yeah. I bet another song.
Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah, well, now let's do Closer. We're going to bring out Taylor Swift.
and she brought jam and biscuits.
She's right there, yeah.
Are you back
biscuits
there?
Biscuits for everyone.
All I wanna get is a little bit closer. All I wanna know is, can you come a little closer? Here comes a breath, deep up, yeah, a little bit closer. Here comes a rush, deep up, we touch, come a little closer. The sun is finally setting, night sky is changing over. It's not just our physical, I'm a type who won't get up so pretty close. So let's make things physical, I won't treat you like you're up so typical. I won't treat you like you're typical. You think a lady is getting underneath me. All I dream of lately is how to get you underneath me. Because of you, before we need a little bit closer. Because of spark, before the dark, come a little closer. Lights are up and the sun is finally setting. It's not just our physical, I'm the type who won't get us so critical. So let's make things physical, I won't treat you like you're all so typical. I want you close, I want you, I won't treat you like you're typical. I want you close, I want you, I won't treat you like you're typical. Ooh, ooh.
Tegan and Sara.
New album, Love You to Death, is out at the Riv tonight. A sold-out show. Thank you guys for being
thanks.
In the Sound Lounge.
Thanks for having us. Thanks, you guys.
Next time, Metal Band?
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Tegan
yeah.
and Sara, the Metal Band.
We're going to really, 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 really change things up for the next
awesome.
Record. Yeah.
Thank you so much. You guys are fantastic.
thanks,
thank
guys.
You. Sara, please.
Thanks, you guys.
That's what you're coming. And
no, I think